Hi, I'm Hilary Russo. Thanks for joining me for the HIListically Speaking Podcast. I'm a certified holistic health coach and havening techniques practitioner, lover of great conversation, and of course, clever wordplay, HIListically Speaking. So welcome to an empowering place where my guests share their transformational stories of trauma to triumph through health, healing, and humor. It's the ultimate brain candy as we find out who we are, how we got that way, and what it takes to be a happy and healthy grown-up, and be kind to your mind. I'm glad you're here. I know the girl. Gratitude. It's a word we hear often during the month of November, isn't it? As we prepare the table for family and friends to gather, as we kick off the official start of the holiday season, as we take a look back on what the year has brought us, the gains, the losses, the celebrations, the challenges. But here's something to think about. What happens after the table is empty again? When all those 30-day challenges of giving thanks have passed? When we're back in our own thoughts, alone? How do we spend those days? How do we grow? And more importantly, how do we stay connected to others and ourselves, even in the silence? On my very first episode of HIListically Speaking, which now feels like forever ago, Chris Schembra joined me to share more about the importance of gratitude and human connection. Now, Chris is known for bringing people together in the most beautiful way at his 747 dinners. And I know this. I've been to many. And I can tell you this. The secret is definitely in the sauce. So as we prepare the dinner tables, take a few moments to enjoy some highlights from episode one as we head to Italy, discover ways to connect, find balance in slowing down, and of course, asking that one question that may open your mind and your heart.
If you could give credit or thanks to one person in your life that you don't give enough credit or thanks to, who would that be? And we ask that question very strategically. We're not asking our dinner table, what's your biggest fear? What's your biggest failure? What do you do for a living? You know, what's your biggest goal? Those are either intimidating questions or they're bullshit surface level questions. We're asking them to pause and reflect on their past and tell a story of someone who helped them get to where they are today that they've just never thanked. And so what happens, it's scientifically proven that when you can use gratitude as a tool to recall positive autobiographical memories from your past, that enhances well-being. What we're also doing is sometimes people will tell a story of someone that wronged them. And so we're actually helping them have a cathartic, what we call gratitude intervention, to get over a negative relationship in their life so that they can release that strain from the past. This impacts well-being, and this helps, you know, gratitude helps form pro-social bonds, which lead to lasting loyalty and trust and empathy and well-being, so many things.
Yeah, I love that you mentioned that because just in my own experience, and I did not think I was going to go there, joining you on that first dinner virtually when I was asked that question, and I'm used to the one asking the question, so already right there, you know, holding space for somebody to be able to ask me was one thing. But then being asked that question, I found myself thanking a relationship that had done me wrong. Somebody that was a former, you know, my ex that I felt was, there was a toxicity to it. But in that moment, when even you mentioned that the top people, most people ask, most people think are their family, like their parents, their siblings, a friend or a stranger, or someone who's done you wrong. I actually found myself thanking that relationship because it brought me to where I am today. And it's allowing us to release. And by having gratitude and being in a state of gratitude is something I always share with my clients. Like, let's find one thing that we can savor in our lives, or gratitude, or have grateful feelings towards. And you find yourself in a much more happy state.
I used to think that I had to be kind of halfway in between a crazy hustle guy and a lazy, you know, slow guy. I used to think I had to find Zen in between, but no, I'm borderline bipolar and I'm cool with that. The land of Emilia Romagna is such a great case study. It's a land of it's a land of two different energies. They call it slow food and fast cars. The region is the largest exporter of food in Italy and a great exporter of culture. You've got four big towns in Emilia-Romagna. You have Bologna, which is where tortellini and tagliatelle and ragu alla bolognese and mortadella, which is known as bologna. It also has the oldest university in the world is there. The town next to it is called Modena. Modena is known as the land of balsamic vinegar, the Modena, which you know, takes 25 to 120 years, you know, just to be good. Modena is the birthplace of Luciano Pavarotti and opera, but it's also the land of the birthplace of Ferrari, Lamborghini, De Tomaso, Ducati. And then the town next to it is Reggio Emilia, which is known for Parmigiano Reggiano, which is another slow food. You know, it takes a couple of years to age. And then the town next to it is called Parma, with Prosciutto di Parma, which again takes a few years. So it's the land of slow food and fast cars. And that's my life right now. I am, on one hand, still an opportunist. You know, I just, you know, I just keep going and keep hustling. But on the other hand, you know, I'm studying plants and I'm slowing down and I'm sitting and taking time for myself. So it's good to be a little of both for me.
Yeah, I love that you kind of created such a visual right there. That first of all, I want to hop on a plane to Italy right now and connect to my Italian roots. But the other thing I love about the visual you created is it reminds me so much of another thing you mentioned in the books, that you and I are so on the same page here, the blue zones, which Italy has areas that are considered the blue zones, which I love talking about these areas, and I would love to move to one myself. But that whole idea of the longevity that people are seeing that are living in areas of the blue zone, where what matters is connection and community and, you know, good food and sustainability and the things that the principles that make up the blue zones, it is so much based on community and connection and eating well and enjoying the time. These people are living to their into their 100s because of that, and they're living well. It's not like they're living connected into different kinds of medical devices. They're living well and they're happy. So that kind of visual kind of is what makes me think about your Italian adventure, you know, it really does. And then you're bringing it back in with this, the pasta and gratitude, you know, and that just, it just seems like it truly is the sauce of life, is connection, community, gratitude, empathy for self, empathy for others, the resonance that we sometimes miss. Is we need to be able to see what it's like to be in the other person's shoes.
Oh, yeah.
You know, the resonance of life, which is so important. And if more people feel that way and see things that way, I think we can connect more.
Connectors, we have to overly communicate what we need. Because if we don't communicate what we need, people won't know what to give. They'll just assume you're already taken care of. And if I just communicate to my audience once a year saying, invite me to more parties, please, the invites will come.
So one last thing I'd love to know before I let you go, what is one takeaway that you would leave with listeners that joined us today?
Pick a date. Pick a date. I don't know what the statistics are, but majority of people who have a dream, who have a vision, who want to do good, they fail to make the first step. And and the first step, as we've proven it time and time again, pick a date, work backwards. That's it.
Love it.
That's it.
Great.
Learn more about Chris Schembra and the 747 Club by visiting the link on the podcast page. And if you want to hear the full episode with Chris, just visit episode 1 and enjoy the conversation. If this episode or any of the Holistically Speaking podcast conversations have touched, moved, or inspired you in any way, consider sharing it with just one person and spread the gratitude and connection forward. And why not subscribe and stay supported and in the know? And as a special gift to you, my listeners, and backed by popular demand, I'm elated to share the Gratitude Enhavening guided video session with you. Just visit HilaryRusso.com/havening and grab it to watch anytime you need some sweet inspiration to be kind to your mind. And let me say this, how grateful I am to a few folks that make this show possible. Thank you to my producer, Alan Seals, for all of your dedication to putting this out there on the podcast space. To Lipbone Redding, my dear friend, for your energy, your music, and your vibe. And to Squadcast for holding space for us to have these conversations. And you, my friends, my dear listeners, thank you for being here week after week. You're why I do what I do with pure love and honest light. I'm forever grateful. So on that note, enjoy your time at the table. Ask those questions. Be kind to your mind. And don't forget to laugh.